30 years after the Salt Iron raged across Norzelia, a vein of precious minerals was unearthed in the kingdom of Glenbrook. From east to west, joy swept the land. United at last in common cause, the kingdom of Glenbrook, the Grand Duchy of Esfrost, and the holy state of Hyzant endeavored to wrest this bounty from the earth, with each nation providing expertise and resources. This uneasy alliance between once bitter enemies will herald a new era of tranquility in this long embattled realm. One after another, dignitaries from each nation arrive in Glenbrook to solidify this accord and toast to its success, the first step on the road to peace. Among those who would forge this road is Serenoa Wolffort. Inheriting the title of Lord Wolffort from his father Simon, he must decide what foundation he would lay for this new era.
Welcome to Castle Wolffort, Minister Lila. Allow me to express my gratitude to the Holy State. Were it not for your nation's generous efforts, this venture would never have come to fruition.
You are too kind, Lord Simon. You too have served an invaluable role in this. Though I must admit, the news of the union between your son and Lady Frederica came as quite the surprise. None in Hyzant considered that a bannerman of Glenbrook would join with the ruling family of Esfrost. I hear that Lady Frederica is the Archduke's half-sister. I must ask, how did this arrangement come to be?
Your curiosity is only natural. This union was promised during the war, an arrangement made with the previous Archduke. Truth be told, I am surprised one as well informed as yourself did not already know.
And this is your son, as I recall.
Serenoa Wolffort, at your service, Minister.
And I am Frederica Esfrost.
My son still has much to learn, but I believe this marriage will herald a bright future for us all. For today, I intend to step down and leave House Wolffort in Serenoa's capable hands.
You're abdicating your position? Surprising news comes in pairs, I see. Nonetheless, I am happy for you both. I imagine the lords and ladies at tonight's banquet will take great interest in the new Lord Wolffort, as will I.
Go easy on the boy, my lady.
I hear that young Lord Dragan of Esfrost shall also be in attendance.
Indeed. He has been appointed to oversee operations at the Grand Norzelian Mines. I understand his star in Esfrost has seen a meteoric rise.
Good. I would like to hear more of this new explosive substance he means to use to blast the tunnels. As a fellow scholar of sorts, if in a different field, I am always curious to learn how great discoveries are made.
He should have arrived by now. Has anyone seen him?
Dragan's gone to see the city. He was halfway there before the gangplank landed on the docks.
Ah, he is your cousin, yes. I see we share an innate curiosity for new places.
The banquet will begin soon. I shall seek him out and escort him there.
Very good. Though I will host tonight's festivities, I want you to act as if you're already Lord of the House. Our guests are the most esteemed personages of their respective nations. Take care not to cause offense.
Of course, Father.
I thank you for your hospitality today, Lord Serenoa.
Think nothing of it. Did you enjoy the city, Lord Dragan?
Quite. Its people are full of life and love for their lord. That says all I need to know about House Wolfort.
You honor us with your words.
I am only being frank. Frederica is the sister of the Archduke, after all, and my cousin besides. I would not see her marry into an unworthy house. Suffice to say, my expectations were exceeded.
I have heard much of your ingenious contributions to the mining efforts. I sense prosperous days are ahead of us.
As do I. Finally, our nations enter into an age unfettered by war. With Esfrost's iron, Hyzan's salt, and Glenbrook's mediation, there is no limit to what we can achieve. We must regard each other as equals, and forge mutually beneficial relationships.
I sense skepticism in your words, Lord Dragan. Do you mean to imply our relations are not already mutually beneficial?
I need not imply anything. The salt tax you claim makes my case more than clear.
Bold words from one so young. Is that how peers speak to one another?
Perhaps the young ones, yes. What do you think, Lord Serenoa?
Dissatisfaction with the salt tax was one cause of the war, was it not?
Salt is a divine boon, a gift from the goddess to her true believers. This is the foundation of the teachings that guide us in Hyzant. By allying with Esfrost, do you mean to gainsay our most fundamental beliefs?
Of course not, Minister. We understand that the source is Norzelia's sole supply of salt, and we would not deny that it is the Holy State's right to harvest and tax it as you see fit.
Thank you for acknowledging that, though it strikes me that your words are measured.
You needn't be so non-committal, Lord Serenoa. It is only reasonable that the three of us have differing opinions on the matter. However, that is all the more reason for us to be open to frank discussion.
Honored guests, pray forgive my son. We of House Wolfort are but simple warriors. I'm afraid matters of finance and politics do not come to us naturally. This, however, I can say. We will fight injustice and tyranny wheresoever it may be. Of course, we do not enjoy conflict. Still, we will not hesitate to defend our land and our people should the need arise. No matter how mighty the threat, we will fight for home and kingdom.
Yes, Lord Simone. Of that we are keenly aware.
I apologize if I spoke out of turn. But the fact remains that as every winter passes, the tension between our nations grows, and salt is the cause. The common folk have all but forgotten its taste. I simply want to ease their suffering.
The ministry I oversee is committed to the preservation of life. I personally believe that salt should not be a luxury reserved for the privileged few. All those who live require it. Not just those lucky enough to be born within the borders of our holy state.
You agree with me, then?
How I feel matters little. In Hyzant, the word of the goddess, as conveyed to us from the lips of the Hierophant, is absolute. But perhaps this joint mining venture of yours may lead to the change you seek.
Indeed. We must set our gazes to the future. All of us. I expect you will be the ones to usher us into a new era.
Yes, Father.
Now that's what I call a feast.
You've landed quite the catch, Frederica.
He is a good man. I can see it in his eyes.
You are too kind, Lord Dragan.
And humble as well.
Are you impressed as I, Frederica?
I can tell that your heart is pure and gentle, my lord.
Lady Frederica.
Forgive me if I caused offense. I thought only to return your sincerity in kind.
No apologies are needed. I am happy to meet your approval.
I... thank you, my lord.
Words come so easily to the both of you.
A perfect match.
Forgive my curiosity. What sort of life did Lady Frederica lead in Esfrost?
Her life? Truth be told, my dear Serenoa, not a pleasant one. Those of Rosellan blood are looked down upon in Esfrost, even if they are the daughter of the Archduke's concubine. Gustadolf's full siblings are the worst of the lot. They have not a shred of human compassion between them. They cruelly bully the girl endlessly, regardless of time or place.
Is this...
true? Of course it is. I know Frederica's suffering all too well. My own father lived ever in the shadow of his elder brother, the former Archduke. Our house, too, is met with sneers by those who consider themselves our betters. But no more. I shall show all those simpering fops that it is not birth that makes greatness, but deeds. And so I did my due research at the archives, that my grand invention shall blast our way forward.
Dragan, please. I believe you've had enough to drink.
You can hardly blame me for availing myself of Glenbrook's finest libations, brought by traders from the realm over. Each cask more exotic than the last. Why, to not partake would be an affront to our newfound allies.
Just make sure your head is clear for tomorrow. Or have you forgotten you're meant to be representing your nation?
Yes, a ceremony to usher in a new age of harmony and prosperity. I am too young to have known the war, so I see our three nations joining hands more as a matter of expedience. But what of you, my kin-to-be? How do you see our grand cooperative venture?
It will benefit all nations involved. I see nothing wrong with that.
Indeed. I didn't know you had such a mercantile mind, Serenoa.
Coin drives the hearts of men and nations alike. I suspect all parties wouldn't be so eager to join hands if not for the promise of profit. And when we're all able to fill our coffers, perhaps we can finally let go of old grudges.
A sensible perspective. I didn't know you had such a practical mind. In any event, it is always good to have another perspective on matters. Let me tell you what I believe. I believe we're on the cusp of a great achievement! As always, it is the young who must bear the burden of building the future. Old shoulders are frail, old minds stubborn. Whatever lies in our future, those who make it will mark their names in history. And mine will be written large for all to see! And I would write yours next to it, my dear cousin. Pray, come visit me at the mines once operations are underway, and I shall...
Trigan, are you quite all right?
Worry not, Frederica. I'm just a bit tipsy. Perhaps I should just lie...
It would seem Lord Dragan has turned in for the night.
Quite the passionate fellow, isn't he?
He's never been one to hide his ambition, ever since we were little. Neither does he hide his disapproval of my brother and trueborn siblings.
Feelings which you share?
I grant it would be satisfying to see the sneers of those who look down on me wiped from their faces. But I also agree with Lord Simon that we must set our gazes to the future. Though I know not yet how I might best serve in this new age, I would do what I can.
We are of the same mind in that regard, my lady. Let us ease the weight of each other's burdens.
Please, call me Frederica. We are to be husband and wife after all.
Of course, my... Frederica. Pray, call me Serenoa as well. We should carry your cousin to his chambers. Will you help me, Frederica?
Certainly, Serenoa. Let us take care not to wake him, lest he resume his prattle.
Benedict, I thought I might find you here.
My lord.
Did you tell her that Serenoa would soon be taking over as lord of our house?
Forgive me, my lord. I did not think to...
Save your apologies, Benedict. Doubtless she was overjoyed to hear it from you. Destra always did trust you above all her advisors. As do I. For 30 years you have served my house better than I ever could have asked for.
You honor me, my lord.
My lord? I suspect this will be the last night I will hear those.
My lord, I will call for a healer at once.
Do not bother, Benedict. It will avail me not. You know as well as I how my heart now fails me.
My lord.
And so I entrust Serenoa to you. For our house. Pray heed this old man's final order.
Certainly. I will live to serve your son until I breathe my last.
Did you hear that, Destra? Our boy is in good hands. My old dear friend. Long have we stood together.
I will not let you down, my lord.
My beloved son, Serenoa will oversee the matters of our house from this day forward. I expect you to serve him as dutifully as you served me.
Of course, Lord Simon.
I, my lord, our undying loyalty to House Wolford.
My son, listen well. A lord's judgment shapes the fates of his kin and subjects alike. Responsibility for their well-being now falls on your shoulders. You must lead them well.
Yes, father. I shall keep those words close to my heart. To that end, I require wise counsel. Together, you possess a wealth of experience. As Lord of House Wolford, it is my duty to consider the best course from every perspective afforded me. I shirk not from this responsibility. At the same time, I would be a fool to not seek guidance from those more traveled than I. For my house and my people, I trust I can rely on you.
Well spoken, my son. I dare say you are more than ready to receive this.
The Scales of Conviction, a holy relic said to be blessed by the deities of old.
It was gifted to our family by the King of Glenbrook. From this day on, I entrust it to you. However, it is of little use without these.
Coins. 7 of them.
Tokens of conviction, we call them. Give one each to only your most trusted retainers and allies. They will guide you when the path is darkest. Their words will illuminate the pitfalls ahead. Heed well the advice of your friends and subjects, and choose your steps carefully. Such has been the way of our house, and such you must see it always shall be.
I will, Father. I shall treasure these gifts and make wise use of them in times of need.
Very good. Now do your duty, my son.
We await your orders, my lord.
We depart for the capital at once. May this ceremony be but the first of many joyous occasions ahead of us.
And so the stewardship of House Wolffort passes from father to son. Lord Simone Wolffort, beloved throughout Glenbrook, entrusts the future to young Serenoa. With the ceremony to mark the beginning of the joint mining venture and a tourney on the horizon, the Wolfforts set forth to the Crown City. With no heroic deeds yet to his name, the new Lord Wolffort sets his eyes on the proving grounds, eager to show his worthiness.
Sir Lord Simon will step down. I suppose the time comes for us all to pass on the torch eventually. What wisdom has your father bestowed upon you?
He has told me what it means to be lord of a house.
Very good. Serenoa of House Wolffort, the Crown of Glenbrook now looks to you for loyal service and brotherhood.
Yes, your majesty. I shall not disappoint.
I dare you to say that again, Thallus.
Must you make me repeat myself? I am the Prime Minister of Esfrost. I and I alone am fit to represent our nation. Go push your papers in the shadows like the minor lordling's son you are.
You would shame me? You, who would be nothing if not for your high birth. Your ineptitude is mocked by noble and commoner alike.
Dragan, you forget yourself.
You both forget yourselves.
Frederica?
If you must bray at each other, then do so back home. Your bickering will bring shame upon our nation.
Such strong words, sister. Do you think you're above us now that you're being wed to mighty House Wolfort?
Please, Erica.
My apologies, but the ceremony will begin soon. I ask the delegates of each nation to make their preparations.
And you must be Sarah Noah Wolfort. Well, I suppose we should bother the happy couple no longer. Well done, Frederica. I see you've inherited your mother's wiles. She always did have a way with men.
Too bad you also inherited her hair. That sickly pink makes me want to retch.
Pray forgive my cousins, Lord Serenoa, and forgive me if I was out of line.
Those two, they were...
Phallus and Erica Esfrost, full brother and sister to Archduke Gustadolf, and my half-siblings.
I see. Well, I hope that we can all come together for the sake of our grand endeavor.
Thank you.
my honored guests. I am pleased to announce that operations at the Grand Norzelian Mines have commenced in earnest.
The Earth has yielded treasures more magnificent than even we had anticipated. May the mines endure for many years as a symbol of prosperity for all of our nations.
Well said. With Hyzant's salt and capital, Esfrost's ingenuity, and Glenbrook's raw materials and manpower, our realm's future is bright indeed. It is a partnership built on three pillars, each bearing equal weight. We owe a debt of gratitude for all who have supported this grand venture. A particular note is Lord Dragan, whose knowledge has allowed us to so swiftly see our labor bear fruit. And House Wolfort, whose mediation has proved invaluable in forming this accord. May their deeds be forever remembered by history. Let us raise our cups and toast to their health and happiness.
Huzzah! Huzzah!
Lord Serenoa is smiling from ear to ear. Shame his parents couldn't be here to see this.
Do not get too swept away in the moment, Erador. We have a job to do here, and the day has only begun.
Now that the formalities are done with, let the festivities begin. Step forward, Sir Maxwell.
So, this is the one they call the Dawn Spear.
Glenbrook's fiercest warrior. They say he has never known defeat.
I would take the measure of this man.
Now that the foundations for peace have been laid, let us be stifled by rigid formality no longer. There is a tourney to be had, after all. A much more entertaining event than my endless speeches.
Here, here, here!
Here, here!
Will any among you prove a match for our Sir Maxwell, the champion of our previous challenge? I very much look forward to finding out. Until then, help yourselves to our hospitality and our wine.
Eat, drink, and be merry. It shall not be long until final preparations are complete.
Our time is nigh, Serenoa. Ah, but I forget myself. Our time is nigh, Lord Wolfort. Congratulations, my friend.
Thank you. But living up to the title will be no easy task.
You'll do your father proud, I'm sure. Unlike some of us.
Preparing for the tourney will take your mind off your worries.
Training? And here when your friend is troubled by doubt.
Did you expect me to comfort you as your wet nurse once did?
Your new titles made you bold. Just because you've become Lord, it doesn't mean I'll sit back and take your barbs unanswered.
Haha, now that's the Roland I know.
At least my wet nurse wasn't so smart.
You two were quite the pair, aren't you?
Fast friends from the day we met. And you are?
Apologies for not introducing you sooner. This is Huet of the Kingsguard.
I am tasked with keeping His Highness safe, though he often seems to resent it. 'Tis a pleasure to meet you, Lord Wolfort.
Ah, Prince Roland has told me much about you. I can see he is in good hands.
I shall see that it is so, my lord.
Now, let us begin our preparations. Today we take the field, and today...
Today we claim victory.
The combatants have arrived, and the stage has been set. Let us introduce the champions who will fight for the glory of their nations. Fighting for the honor of the Grand Duchy of Esfrost, General Avlora. Fighting for the honor of the Holy State of Hyzant, Minister Exham Marshall. Fighting for the honor of the Kingdom of Glenbrook, House Wolfort. And last but not least, the victor of our previous tourney, Sir Maxwell, the Dawnspear!
Hurrah! Hurrah!
The Wolfort Lordling is here in his father's stead, I see.
Lord Simone's heroics on the battlefield are the stuff of legend. A pity I couldn't match swords with him today.
You will match swords with me. I promise to make it every bit as exhilarating as father would.
You have his spirit, if nothing else.
Indeed. I look forward to crossing swords with you.
The combatants have assembled. Now, let the battles begin. I shall announce our first pairing as chosen by lots. Minister Exham and Lord Wolfort, make ready for combat.
Be gentle, my lords. I'm not as strapping as once I was.
I expect no quarter from you, Prince Roland, nor from you, Lord Serenoa. Show us the swordplay your house is so famous for.
They're two of Hyzant's most famed generals. We'll have no room for mistakes.
Then we shall make none. Now, let us show the realm the medal of the new generation.
For honor and glory!
My turn.
Take that!
You are not worthy of my time.
Here I come.
For the honor of House Wolfort.
Ha!
Leave it to me! Yes! No! Oh! Damn it! Don't lose heart, Sarah Noah. Show them that the Wolfhorts never back down!
I see a path to victory. It is time to strike.
Splendid.
I've been waiting for this.
A waste of effort.
How shall I destroy you?
Shall we begin? Your wounds are healed.
This will help.
Allow me. I will end this.
I'm a fool.
This was destined
close.
To occur.
Not quite.
This battle is ours. You'll get no mercy from us.
What would Father do? Perish.
Together.
I shall try my level best. I have your back.
I can do it. Out!
Now!
I shall do what I can. Allow me. I can keep fighting. I will end this.
Ah!
to ashes!
To work then!
I ain't that slow!
Your orders?
Worthy of my time.
Your lifeblood shall paint my sword.
This battle is ours. Darkness engulfs you.
There is no mercy on the battlefield. Let us reverse our fortunes.
How shall I destroy you?
Shall we begin? Be at ease.
That's the stuff.
I'll take you on.
Allow me. Your orders? This will prove useful. Suffer.
You are not worthy of my time. It ends here.
No!
This was destined to occur.
Darkness engulfs you. Almost.
My aid is yours.
I see a path to victory.
Ha!
I have your back.
This is...
How shall I destroy you?
Too obvious. Allow me. Two ashes.
You won't beat me!
You're open. Your orders?
Have another! You're wide open!
Shall we begin?
The hunt is on. He stands now!
Let us pry out their weakness.
How could this be?
This can't be!
By her grace!
Lord hurt.
Let me show you what I've learned. Here I come! We can win this! We will make our ideals reality. I will end this.
How annoying.
Time to take flight. This ends now. We win. My pride is my shield.
Exham, I will leave you to fight for the...
I see a path to victory.
My turn, brute!
Just
my
as
turn.
I planned.
I will end this. Allow me. You won't escape. I feel stronger already.
Goddess, I thank you for your blessing.
Let me show you what I've learned. Flame, heed my call!
This is nothing. There's no joy in an easy victory.
This ends now!
I asked for no quarter. You did not disappoint.
To think they'd get the better of us.
Your father taught you well. You wield that greatsword with skill beyond your years. Well fought. The day is yours.
Victory goes to House Wolfort! Our next bout shall be between General Avlon.
Stand back. This one is mine.
Very well. I accept your challenge. Whoever taught you, they taught you well. Though something tells me you surpassed your teacher long ago. Your defense is formidable.
As is yours. I yield.
Victory goes to Sir Maxwell.
My hand. I can't feel it. So that was General Avlora. I pray never to meet her on the battlefield. There will be no quarter given today, young lord of House Wolfort.
I would expect nothing less. Huh? Where am I?
Ah. You're awake. And none the worse for wear, considering the blow you took from Sir Maxwell.
He was too strong for us in the end.
Today, yes. But let us keep at our training. One day, the students will surpass their master.
Let us work hard for that day, my friend.
Sarah Noah and his stalwart allies prove their mettle against the realm's fiercest warriors before finally facing Sir Maxwell, victor of the previous tourney. After a hard-fought match, the Dawnspear emerges victorious once more. Though beaten in the end, Sarah Noah's courageous display impresses itself upon all in attendance. Any doubts concerning House Wolfort's martial might are put to rest. Thus marks an end to the tourney and the festivities as a whole. With the spirit of harmony in their hearts, the delegates of each nation make preparations for their return voyages.
Seeing our honored guests off shall be your last lordly duty this day. Now, I remind you.
It is not to be taken lightly. Worry not, Benedict. They shall be sent off with all the pomp they deserve.
You take to your new role well, Lord Sarah Noah. As I must now take to my own. Pray, visit me at the mines whenever you have the time.
Well, Frederica, may we never meet again.
Thank you for such a productive use of our valuable time. I do so love interminable speeches and watching brutes play at war. Truly, the spirit of Glenbrook was on display for all to see. But I should watch my tongue. Wouldn't want her to go whimpering to brother.
Pay my fool cousin no mind. We have work to do. Work more important than any he could hope to be trusted with.
I apologize for those two. This was a fruitful day for all in attendance.
I am glad to hear you say so, General Aflora.
I can't believe we lost. I thought you were supposed to be one of Hyzant's greatest warriors.
Our foe was a worthy one. It would be an honor to cross blades again someday.
Thank you for your hospitality. Please give my regards to Lord Simone.
Of course, Minister.
It would seem everyone is gathered. You'll find your boats are laden with a bounty of Glenbrook's finest wares and victuals. King Regna asks that you eat and drink your fill, and toast to our three nations' newfound alliance.
More of that swill you call wine? I suppose I could force myself to partake.
Your king honors us with his generosity. We shall present these as offerings to the Goddess of Salt. The Hierophant, too, will no doubt be overjoyed.
Lord Wolford, I bring a message from King Regna. He would have you join our guests on their return voyage to serve as their envoy.
This is a great honor, my lord. You would represent our nation and speak with the king's voice.
If it is His Majesty's wish, it is a duty I will gladly accept. But there are two vessels and only one of me. Did King Regna say which of our honored guests I should accompany?
He would leave that decision to you, Lord Wolford.
Lord Falks, as representative of another of Glenbrook's high houses, will board the ship you do not.
And why was House Tellior not given this honor? Last I knew, our kingdom had three high houses, not two.
Mere fact that you whimper those words before us is answer enough.
Good show at the tourney, Lord Serenoa. You truly are your father's son. The king has seen fit to leave this decision in your hands, and I shall not gainsay his wisdom.
A lord must be worldly as well as wise. I trust you will conduct yourself as befits the lord of a high house.
Thank you, Sir Maxwell, Lord Falks.
The king has entrusted this decision to you, my lord. I suppose you have an idea as to why.
He means to test my judgment. He is waiting to see which I choose and for what reason.
Indeed. We are friendly with both nations now, so neither choice will earn his ire. That said, there is no telling how these relations may change going forward. No doubt, the choice you make will have an effect on our own house's relationship with the nation you choose.
I understand. This requires careful consideration. Benedict, gather the others. I would hear their opinions on the matter. Then we shall consult the scales of conviction.
At once, my lord.
Thank you.
Your orders?
You don't stand a chance. Yes!
This is good. Frederica. I'm sorry.
Defeat is not an option. On your guard. What have we here?
I see a path to victory. All for victory.
Thank you. My turn.
For victory! Take that! I shirk from no danger! Defeat is not an option. Perish. I've gained new strength.
Let us pry out their weakness. Let us reverse our fortunes. I see the threads of battle more clearly. My lord! Ah!
I will end this. To ashes. Time to work. This is the end.
I have failed. Forward!
This ends here!
These foes are not to be trifled with. I have your back.
You have my thanks. I fight for peace. We win. My turn.
Allow me. My turn. This is the end. One more.
Forward. Wait your turn.
I struck through. That seemed to work.
Mother.
I must find a way. Stay composed.
Much appreciated.
Time to work.
Ha! Sound strike.
You've left yourself open.
It's over. Victory is the
You've left yourself open. From where shall we strike? This ends here.
Victory is not yet out of reach. A brief respite.
I will end this.
Allow me.
For the honor of House Wolfort, perish.
Thank you.
It seems your first test as Lord has come. Tis no small matter either.
Indeed, but I needn't face it alone. I would ask each of you where you think we should go and why. State your case before the scales of conviction. Then we shall decide our destination.
We take a vote and the consensus determines our action. Is that it?
That is correct. So long as my allies walk by my side, their opinions carry equal weight to mine. Such is the way of House Wolfort. As Lord, I shall bear the weight of consequence for the scale's decision, whatsoever they may be.
You are more serious than usual, my friend.
He understands what it means to be Lord of his house.
Well, I hope you have room for a stowaway, because I'm going to. In secret, of course. I trust the new Lord Wolfort will handle the ponderous negotiations of diplomacy with grace.
Your Highness, you cannot be...
You may stay ashore if you wish, Yuet.
You know I cannot allow that. If you insist on going, then I shall attend you.
Well then, it would seem the matter is settled.
There is exactly one coin for each of us.
It seems fate has conspired to bring balance to our proceedings.
How curious.
Curious? I see it as a sign that the heavens approve of my joining you.
You are ever the optimist, my friend.
Shall we proceed, my lord? One coin, one vote.
Very well. I would hear each of your thoughts on the matter in turn. Then you shall place your coin upon the scales of conviction and illuminate the road ahead.
Serenoa. And? I see.
Lord Serenella. Certainly not. I am decided.
Lord, sir.
Possibly. My mind is made up.
It is time to cast our votes. Do we journey to the Grand Duchy of Esfrost, or the Holy State of Hyzant? Approach the Scales of Conviction with your token.
Forgive me, my lord.
I am so sorry.
You aren't wrong, but...
Scales of Conviction will... The way forward is decided. We journey to Hyzant. Decided. We set sail for them. Whether or not it proves to be the right choice will depend on.
We are ready to set sail, Lord Patriot.
Very good, my lord. When you pay respects to the Holy One and the Saintly Seven, remember that you do so.
Lord Serenoa. We are honored that you would choose to grow. That said, I must offer.
It may be in Lady Frederica's best interests to remain. I fear there may be some...
She is half-sister to the Archduke and my betrothed besides.
None, if I had any say in it. However, the matter...
Your lady's hair would draw attention.
My mother's hair. The pink lock... Mother once told me of how her people...
Then you know how the Rozal are viewed in our nation. How the Gospel of the God is regarded.
Yes, I do. But I am from Esfrost, and I assure you I have committed me.
Of course, my lady. Very well, then. I will do all in my power to...
Thank you.
You've no need to apologize. Still, I must...
I must go. I would see with my own eyes. See where, and...
By order of King Regna, Serenoa escorts their esteemed guests back home, beyond the forest and over the mountains to a vast, sand-swept land. Before long, a grand wall of stone rises before them. Known as the Goddess's Shield, behind it lies the source, Nozelia's only supply of salt. Upon the lakeshores of the source towers a giant likeness of the goddess, ever watching over the flourishing city and the palace below. This is the holy state of Hyzant.
Tales of the Goddess's Shield, but its grandeur surpasses even my imagination.
It protected the Holy State from both Glenbrook and Esfrost during the war. None in history have succeeded in breaching it. Do you think you might fare better, Lord Serenoa?
I think penetrating these walls would be nigh impossible.
A most courteous answer. I should have expected as much.
Could this be?
Is this the hour of worship I've heard so much about?
Indeed. Hyzantians offer their prayers up to the goddess's statue every day. They thank her for her blessing, for bestowing us with the source, from which all Norzalia's salt is harvested.
To see every citizen pray is astonishing.
Thank you.
goddess truly is at the center of all Hyzant, just as the stories say.
Thank you. Even so, are there none who'd use this time of worship to rob their fellow citizens?
There are none so misguided among the goddess's believers. Thank you.
All Hyzantians are guaranteed food, clothing, and shelter. The Holy State has done everything in its power to eliminate poverty and ensure equality. As a result, no one envies others or craves riches for selfish reasons.
Certainly, if everyone were equal, there would be naught to fight about.
But achieving absolute equality is impossible.
The words of an unbeliever. The goddess showers her blessings fairly upon all who follow her teachings.
Before we visit the Hierophant, there is one thing I must tell you about Lady Frederica.
Under normal circumstances, the head of our nation would not permit an audience with one of Rosellan extract. We have explained the circumstances, however, and she has been granted special permission to enter the palace as an envoy.
That said, we would ask that Lady Frederica remain silent before the Holy One.
Silent? Why?
I reiterate that typically she would not be so much as allowed to attend. We ask for your understanding of our creed.
Thank you.
to treat one of Glenbrook's delegates as if she weren't even there?
Prince Roland, you are here in secret. It would not do for you to gainsay another nation's religious creed. I have no objections.
My apologies.
You needn't apologize. Let us do what we came here for.
We appreciate your understanding. Now then, let us show you to the palace.
That is where the Hierophant resides.
The Hierophant imparts us with the goddess's divine messages. None are allowed to look upon the Holy One's face. None save Minister Edor, who conveys their divine words to us.
Pardon our intrusion. Lord Serenoa Wolfort of Glenbrook has escorted us home on behalf of King Regnum.
The Hierophant speaks to you. Serenoa Wolfort, we thank you for your gracious gesture. We are overjoyed and humbled that you have chosen to grace our nation with your presence.
I am unworthy of such high praise, but honored nonetheless.
House Wolfort and Hyzant have shared a deep bond ever since the Sultain War. On behalf of the Saintly Seven, it is my wish that our friendship will be as strong as it was with your Lord Father.
But of course, I strive to one day measure up to his greatness.
You will also, in time, succeed Lord Simon as advisor to the mining venture, I hear. The Hierophant would hear your true thoughts on the endeavor.
I think it a significant stepping stone toward peace between the three nations.
A safe reply, to say the least, Lord Serenoa.
It is an ideal that I can only hope is shared by all those involved.
If I might ask, what is the ideal to which the Holy One aspires?
I would share the goddess's blessing with all of Norzelia. The Holy One wishes for a world where people are equal. The goddess always watches over those who believe in her. May you all receive her divine protection.
I apologize for visiting you in secret, but there is something I must ask you. I have heard that the people of Hyzant live in equality. They say the goddess showers blessings upon those who follow her teachings. But is that the only reason?
Oh, a studious one you are, Prince Roland. King Regna has raised you well. Of course, the goddess's teachings are at the core of the equality our citizens enjoy. But there are many measures taken by the Holy State to ensure the happiness of our people.
Minister Lila's Ministry of Medicine, which dedicates itself to the study of preserving life, is another example of this. The results of their research have allowed many people to overcome illness and injury and live long, healthy lives.
Fascinating. I would like to hear more about Hyzant's medical discoveries.
I see we managed to pique your interest. Minister Lila, I leave our guests in your capable hands. Pray, show them around the ministry, and let them admire Hyzant's pursuit of life and magic.
Brother, where is Roland? I've yet to see him today.
Thank you.
And you shan't, for he has left. Took it upon himself to join the mission abroad.
He did? I see.
Again, prioritizing his personal wishes above his station. Is there no end to his selfishness?
You haven't any love for him, have you?
Love? I would rather think of him as little as humanly possible.
How can you say that? He's family.
Royal family, and our duty is to the crown above all. Do not look to Roland for inspiration if you wish to carry yourself in a manner befitting your station, dear Cordelia.
Look, a Rosellan. I heard she's an envoy from Glenbrook.
Be that as it may, is her kind even allowed to enter our halls?
I can only assume she received special permission, since Minister Lila's showing her around.
Ironic, considering the wishes of us researchers are hardly ever granted.
What a splendid facility you have here. I can see why your nation excels in the medical arts.
Normally, only ministry staff are allowed in. Having outsiders view our work is unprecedented.
We cannot thank you enough for your generosity.
If I heard correctly, it sounds like you are researching life itself.
That we are. In order to cure illnesses and injuries, we must set our sights high.
Even illnesses deemed uncurable in other nations?
There is no miracle panacea in this world, but we like to think nothing is impossible.
Wonderful. And would you be willing to share those results with others, should you achieve them?
If you believe in the goddess's teachings, yes. At least, that is what I would expect the Holy One to say.
Minister Lila, the preparations for the experiment are complete.
My apologies, but I must get back to work. You are free to take a look around. However, I ask you to not enter the restricted area.
Of course, nothing is free in the Ministry, nor anywhere in Hyzant. And of course, when people are forced to adhere to teachings, there are some who will resist.
Who might you be?
Just a researcher, nothing more. What was his problem?
Serenoa, I could use some fresh air, if you don't mind.
But of course. Let us take a break outside.
We got our hands on a fine souvenir, thanks to Lady Frederica.
It is quite the feat indeed. Serenoa has terrible taste when it comes to gifts.
Thank you indeed, Frederica.
It was my pleasure.
Should we ask Minister Lila about what ails Lord Simon?
No. Even now, Lord Simon commands great influence. We cannot let others know about his condition.
I understand. Not even our allies can know of our weaknesses, lest they use them against us.
Indeed. We cannot risk exposing ourselves to such danger, for the young lord's sake as well.
What was that?
It appears there is a stir around the ministry.
I shall investigate.
Anna, what happened?
Some researchers at the ministry ran off with its secrets.
To think my ministry was infiltrated by unbelievers!
Unbelievers?
Heathens who reject the goddess's teachings.
At their head is a researcher named Plinius, who escaped with some of our most valuable findings. You must retrieve these documents for us, Exham.
Consider it done. Well, they could be anywhere in town by now. I will need all the eyes I can get on the lookout.
I must remain here at the ministry. Their spies may still be among us.
Minister Exham, we would be happy to be of service.
We are in your debt, Lord Serenor.
The men we pursue are researchers, proficient in the arcane arts. The insight of one versed in their ways would be invaluable to us.
Take Corentin with you. He is one of my most talented researchers. Corentin, you are to go with House Wolfort and help him retrieve our research from Plinius.
As you wish, Minister.
All right, my friends. The pursuit begins!
I won't let you down.
Plinius, give yourself up. There is no escape for heathens like yourself. Even attempting to steal our nation's secrets is a grave crime. One I know you have not forgotten.
This research is my life's work. I have poured my blood, sweat, and tears into it. What is so wrong with treating it as my own?
Plinius, such an untainted passion for knowledge cannot hope to survive here. I had heard that Hyzant was a land without strife. It would seem that was too good to be true.
We mustn't allow Plinius and his lackeys to get away. After them!
Time to work.
For victory!
Very well, then.
The hunt is on.
I needed that.
Forward!
I see a path to victory. Let us steel our defenses.
Our victory is assured.
Let me heal your wounds.
Shall we begin?
I fight for peace. Flame, heed my call! Oh no!
Time for some research. I do not miss.
My turn.
Time to take flight. Take that.
They have to survive. You will regret ridiculing me. The price. Take this.
Gah! Forward!
Shall we begin?
Cool heads shall prevail. Be at ease.
Thank you.
I see a path to victory. I have your back.
I can do it. Allow me.
I'll be fine.
Cold wind blows.
That didn't work.
Damn it!
Your orders? This is the end.
I won't lose! Defeat is not an option. I'll make this quick. Ah! For my kith and kin.
This battle is ours.
You leave me with no recourse.
Freeze! Gah! A pathetic state I am. Your lifeblood shall paint.
There's no joy in an easy victory.
There is no mercy on the battlefield. It is time to strike.
Our victory is assured.
Shall we begin?
Be at ease. Much obliged.
With clear eyes, I move forward. Allow me. Thank you.
to ashes.
Wait!
It worked! This power will protect us.
I'll be fine.
We must tread carefully. I'll take this. I feel stronger already.
My turn. Brace yourself. Defeat is not an option. Wait your turn.
Battle is ours. Take that.
How annoying.
I see a path to victory. Let us steel our defenses.
I won't waste this boon.
For the future of House Wolford.
Shall we begin?
Sorry to worry you.
Let me show you what I've learned.
With the powers in me.
Wait!
I won't give up!
Out of my way!
Inconceivable!
Time for some research.
Orders. Suffer.
My turn.
Hands here.
Defeat is not an option. Parry.
goddess.
What did you hope to do with our secrets? Sell them for riches?
No. We wished only for freedom in our research. Knowing we would be granted no such liberty here, we were left with no choice.
I see. You rebel against her teachings, as I suspected. Take them away. You have our gratitude, Lord Serenoa. We could not have apprehended the heretics without you.
What will happen to them now?
They will be punished for their wrongdoings, of course. Defying the goddess's teachings is the most grave crime one can commit in Hyzant.
I see now. Equality here stems from their thorough elimination of heretics.
You did well, Corentin. For your efforts, you deserve a reward.
If you insist, I do have a request. I would like permission to embark on a journey. I wish to learn more about the medicines of other lands.
Greater knowledge of medicine would prove useful in our studies of life. I will consider it.
We will take our leave here.
Master Corentin, thank you for your help today.
There's something I would speak with you about. Do you have a moment? This place is too conspicuous. Let us talk elsewhere.
You wish to leave Hyzant?
Yes. I wish to study magic, not medicine.
But just before, you spoke of wanting to observe medical treatment in other nations.
Merely a pretense to gain permission to leave. We cannot research freely in Hyzant. We are simply tasked with fulfilling our designated roles. Furthermore, no matter how revolutionary our discoveries may be, the world at large will never know them.
You mean to say you tire of Hyzant's secrecy?
You're not much different than those so-called heretics, then. Could it be you feel some connection with them?
To tell the truth, I was well aware of Plinius' plan. But I was a coward. One who could neither stop nor join them. And because of it, I ended up capturing those with whom I sympathized. I wish never to feel this way again.
And thus you mean to leave the Holy State entirely?
Yes, I have no intention of returning to the Ministry. Which is why I must ask if you would allow me to journey with you as a member of House Wolfort.
My lord, while he may be a unique character, he undoubtedly possesses a great understanding of the arcane.
There is one thing I must know. Would you be troubled traveling alongside my betrothed, knowing her heritage?
Not at all. I'm abandoning Hyzant and the goddess's teachings with it. On the contrary, Lady Frederica's magic fascinates me. I would love to learn more about it.
But of course,
Very well then. Welcome to our ranks, Corentin. Pursue your studies to your heart's content. I only ask that you put them to use on House Wolfort's behalf.
Of course. You have my thanks, Lord Serenoa.